Okay, Lichuta Maran, this is the first shir of Faravav, teaching number 6. Shon Rabbeinu Zal. First Rabbeinu prefaces with the pasuk, V'yoyim Hashem u'Moshe, and Hashem said to Moshe, he told her what? In Kavuya Mechalmus, your day to pass away and approached. Kras Yeshua, you know, call Yeshua. V'itzatzvu be'ol moed, and stand before me in ol moed. V'atzavenu, and I will order him, and you'll be able to pass the baton, you know, from Moshe Rabbeinu to Yeshua. At the end of this Maimar, Bezat Hashem, this pasuk will be explained. This is one of but this is like one of the seminal Torahs of Likutei Maharan. It is the so many of the principles that we speak about all the time on Negea are here in this. They emanate from this particular Torah. This is like this. Kitzorich kol olam lemad kvod atzmoi. Every person has to diminish his own honor. V'la'abos v'kvod ha'makom. And to increase the honor of Hashem. In other words, should be an olav. And don't be so particular on your kavod. And be tzanua, you know, so the people don't give you kavod. And when you're doing mitzvahs, you know, masim tovim, do it for the kavod of Hashem, and not for your own kavod. Ki mi sheroidef achar hakavod, but anybody who is chasing kavod, eino zocheh lechavod melachim, he never retains a godly honor. Ela lechavod shel melachim. The maximum he can get is the kavod of kings, of politicians, of a prime minister, of a mayor, of whatever. But he never gets a god, a divine honor. He doesn't get the kavod Elokim. Now, question is, what do I care? If I like kavod, give me any kind of cover. I don't care, you know, kvod Elokim, kvod Melachim, give me cover. That's what I want. That's what the Taiva is. True, but there's a little problem with kvod Melachim. It says, ki zoich ha'onik kvod Melachim, she'ne'emar bo in the kvod Melachim, kvod Melachim chako davar. In other words, the honor that kings and politicians have is a kind of honor that everybody investigates and probes into it. Does he really deserve it or doesn't deserve it? What do you think? Is a good mayor? Everybody has an opinion. Is a horrible mayor? Is a good mayor? It is everybody's mouth. And that's why that when a person was running after COVID, then he's and takes a cover to himself, he's running for office, he's becoming this. Everybody investigates him, everybody's looking to find out his blemishes. They all ask, who is he? What is he? You know, who is he to get all this covered? Who is this nobody, you know, to be a mayor or to be a member of the Knesset or to be the prime minister? Who is he? Nothing. Not only this, v'cholkim alav, and they dispute him. They said that he doesn't deserve it. The prime minister is doing a horrible job. I mean, you sit down, you know, you go to Tel Aviv, and you see in a cafe, and they're sitting like they have like 20 or 30 tables there, you know, with people around them. You have 20 or 30 different conversations how everything is wrong with everybody else. Every day, this one is blaming, in one table they're blaming the mayor for the sanitation, and another place they're blaming the prime minister for this, and another place they're blaming the wife because of this, and the other table they're blaming the husband because of that, and in other words, it's everybody is just spending their time blaming everybody else. and they have svaras. They have, no, you don't have to go on. And they have svaras and explanations, you know, why.
You have an audience from Tel Aviv.
Yeah, well, you know, Tel Aviv, it can be Manhattan, it can be Mitchell, it can be anyone. But the point is, and they have svaras and they have opinions and they have this and they have that, why this is so. I told you that my mother-in-law, she asked me about a certain point in time, you know, Israel and this and that, and what's my opinion? I told her, I don't know. So she said, I know you don't know, but what's your opinion? I don't know. No, but it's interesting. It's a game that people play. You know, it's, who's to blame? Who's at fault? Whenever something goes wrong over here, they open up a Vaadat Chakira, you know, investigation committee. Who's at fault? What do you care who's at fault? They have to find a scapegoat. You know, that's because without a scapegoat, it means that we didn't learn from it. What did you learn from it? Didn't you learn Gulish Mitnish? That's the way it is. So anybody who pursues honor, he gets Kvod HaMelachim, but he is not, he doesn't get, you know, that's the kind of quality everybody investigates it. Because really, the person, you know, vis-a-vis himself, he doesn't deserve the honor. Because all his honor, all his koiches, and all his talents are mishamayim. Has nothing to do with that. With him. Aval mi sheborach min hakovet, but anybody who runs away from kovet, you don't want any kovet. Leave me alone, I don't need to give me kovet, I don't need to daven by the mizrach, I don't, nothing. Shvimad b'chvod ha'atzmoy, that he diminishes his own kovet, but he increases and he brings about an increase in the covenant, the honor of Hashem. He earns a divine honor. Because then he's totally nullified to Hashem. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives him his own honor, and the honor that he's been given, that is bestowed upon him mishamayim, is not his own personal honor, but it's not that they honor him, they honor the fact that he's an Eved Hashem, and their kavana is what is to honor Hashem. When Rav Steinman comes around, you see the cover that they give him. Who are they giving the cover to? They're giving the cover to Hashem. They're not giving it to Rav Steinman. Rav Steinman doesn't want any cover. Doesn't need it. So the cover that they give to him is a cover to Hashem. The same thing as the cover to Rav Kanievsky. What are you talking about? He himself doesn't want any kovod b'chlal. So what, you're not going to give him kovod, you're going to question his kovod? He doesn't want any kovod b'chlal, he runs away from it. You don't deserve the kovod, I agree. No, what is it to investigate? And so their kavona is to honor Hashem. And he himself is also, he connects and elevates the kovod to Hashem. He doesn't take the kovod to himself. They give the honor to him. So what does he do? He uses it in order to bring them to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He doesn't take it to himself. He doesn't enjoy this kovod. V'az, and b'nei odom chokim ha'kavoida, then people don't investigate, don't dispute his kovod. Im ra'u, im lav. Does he deserve it? Doesn't he deserve it? Well, Avnei Mar, Kvod Elokim Aster Davar. On him it says, The Pasuk says, Kvod Malachim and Mishleim, Ecclesiastes? No, this is Mishleim. Mishleim is not Ecclesiastes. It's Proverbs. Kvod Malachim Chakod. The honor of kings investigate matter. Kvod Elokim Aster Davar. The honor of Elokim of Hashem. What?
Godly honor.
Yeah, godly honor, you know, Aster Davar, you know.
Conceal
it. Because it's forbidden to investigate this honor. If he deserves it or not, because that's the Kavod of Hashem.
Is that really a tzaddik or not?
What?
Does that apply to asking, is he really a tzaddik or not?
What people say or not say is a different thing. When you meet the person, it's a whole different kind of ballgame. There are different kind of inyonim that, you know, by the tzaddikim, that by them, it's already different. There are different inyonim that are involved in this. I'm talking sadinim, and the Rebbe says that many times, when a tzaddik in this world is so strong, it's such a big kitrug on him, the sakana to his life. So they bring another tzaddik to make machlokes on him. You know, and it covering up that way. It's just because of the tzaddik, so it's a tzaddik. And by this, they cover him so he can do his work covertly. So you're dealing with different kind of yoga. We're talking about simple people. Us, the principle is that every person, you run away from COVID and you increase the COVID Kodesh Baruch Hu, you're zecha to Kvod Elokim. And Kvod Elokim, of course, you cannot invest it because the Kodesh Baruch Hu, mother deserves the COVID. You know, what are you, and the person himself, are you questioning? What's your question? He doesn't want any COVID, he's running away from the COVID. You know something? We're not going to put the crown on your head. What are you talking about? I just want my slippers. That's a crown. You know, madman, come off the roof. And he says like this. Okay, so now we've established that a person has to diminish his own cover and raise the cover of Hashem. Is there anybody who runs, who chases after COVID, he gets COVID blocking, he gets the COVID of kings. You can get COVID, but it's the COVID of kings. You're in everybody's mouth, everybody speaks about you, everybody looks, you know, with a fine tooth comb to find out everything you're doing wrong. And then, he's a gomish, he's a horrible, he's the worst president we ever had. He's the worst mayor, He puts in division. He's creating a division. But anybody who runs away from COVID, what do you want to say? I don't deserve COVID. I agree. It's all it takes the wind out of yourselves, doesn't it? If you're going to somebody who doesn't want any COVID, he says, I'm not giving you COVID. Boo-hoo. What have you done, right? Now comes the question, okay, but how do you get this kind of covenant? How do you get this godly covenant, this divine covenant? He have shall his cause the covenant as a to the divine covenant, divine honor. Ela l'idei tshuva. The only way to do it is to do tshuva. As we will explain later on. Ve'ikir tshuva, and the essence of tshuva, this is one of the seminal sentences in Likutei Maharan. Ve'ikir ha-tshuva hu k'shishmat bizyonoi yidol v'ishtoi. The main essence of tshuva is when a person hears his own shame, his own derision, yidol v'ishtoi.
You come back from the field, you did tshuva, and the wife says, why did you take out the garbage? Why did you come home so late?
Ida Meishta, keep your mouth closed. Say when other people deride him, be quiet and accept it in love, because you will feel that really, you really deserve these kind of derisions because of one's avarice. And when a person will look at his own avarice and will listen really carefully and listen to what kind of derisions that he's being derided, he will understand his bizarre from them. And he'll be quiet. He'll be quiet because of the busha. You know, when you're caught red-handed, when what you don't say anything, right? It's like... And a person will be able to tell how much he's actually damaged and blemished through his affairs. How awful is what he did. He will become very, very, very ashamed before HaKadosh Baruch Hu for his avarice, until his, like, his blood is split, is spilling inside him. Zemlosa says Nikut Alochis. And that is, you hear, this is the essence of tshuva, the fact that people, you know, deride you and they shame you, and he's quiet. He doesn't care. On he doesn't, you know, on his own cover. He says, how dare you speak to me like this? You know, nothing like that. Because the only thing he cares about is just to increase the cover of Kodesh Baruch Hu. Zehu tshuva al avaris. This is the tshuva on his avaris. Because all the avaris, they come. Why does a person do avaris? David, I know you don't do avaris, chas v'chalila. But what? Somebody who does. I heard, you know, in Russia, there's somebody who does avaris. It's a rumor.
There's a Russia in Russia.
There's a Russia in Russia. Did you hear about the Russia in Russia?
Russia.
Yeah, there's a Russia in Russia. You know that garbage in Russian is Musar.
Hmm?
Musar. That's the Russian word for garbage.
Wow.
Interesting. You know, it's a thought. It's a thought. It's a Russia in Russia. So how does a Russia come to do an Averis? Because a person looks at Kovad Atzmi, not Kovad Hashem. He's looking for your own pleasure. You don't care about Kovad Hashem. And in this, that a person looks at his own Chatoim, looks at his own, why did it come to me? Because what I did, and he recognizes how much he actually blemished, and is really embarrassed from that, and regrets it, that's the tshuva. Regretting the past and accepting for the future. Okay? Now, by Anash, they always used to say, how is it possible that my tshuva will be dependent on my reaction to what somebody else says? They put me down, they shame me, they this, they that.
The parameter of my tshuva is...
What happens if I'm alone on a deserted island? There's nobody there. Well, I can know the tshuva. So they said, it's not just the derision that you hear from somebody else on the outside. It's when you hear your derision from yourself. And the audience tells us, a big shot, huh? A big spender. I remember years ago in Borough Park, they said, do you remember the Sephardi shul in 14th Avenue, David?
Sorry.
Do you remember the shul of Rabbi Zinger on the Sephardi shul on 47 and 14?
No, not from Borough Park.
There was a shul over there. There was this.
Oh, it was Zinger's father.
Probably. Rav Zinger was the Rav de Shul. It was Rav de Shul there. It's 48th Street. Was it 48th Street? 46th Street. Right. So anyhow,
yeah.
Used to be this Bukharian guy in his 80s. You can see when he was young, he was a mountain of a man. In his 80s, he was still, you know, with this big beard, barrel-chested man. He was going around. And he didn't speak any English. He hardly spoke. Baruch Hashem, he had children that were in Kuelulim, and really good children. And he himself was collecting tzedakah. Was collecting tzedakah. So, you know, some people gave, some people didn't give. You know, he was from Bukhara. You know, from Georgia. You know, one of those places. They don't have the same kind of sense of, you know, this Western kind of like etiquette things. So he would go, he would go there and say, Sadaqah, and he came there with a guy, this guy himself probably was, he's having his old tough time, whatever it is, you know. Smaller guy in his 50s, and, you know, this real sour person, wouldn't give him anything, not only wouldn't give him, wouldn't even look at him. You hear him, David? So the guy is coming to him, and he's telling him, Sadaqah, the guy then says, so the guy, this Bukharian guy, looks at him and says, Olam Haba, huh? He says, Olam Haba, huh? Ah, boo, 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 boo. Olam Haba, huh? Ah, boo, 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 boo. So your inner Bukhari comes to you. Olam Haba, boo 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 boo. And he's right. There's nothing you can say.
Don't say anything.
Yishma bizyoinoi, yidam veishtoik. Listen to your derision and be quiet and keep on doing your own thing. Why are you kidding? I mean, for every mitzvah you do five averas. And here you are, Mr. Big Shot, you know, telling turns to everybody, and what do you do afterwards? You're right. But still. Yishma bizyoinoi. Be quiet. Keep on doing. Don't pay attention to it. You keep on doing. You call this davening? This is davening? When are you davening? You're not going to put any koyach into your davening. You're not any koyach into your davening. You're just not chopping the whole tefillin. Keep on keeping on. Keep on keeping on. Keep on doing what you're doing. Even if it looks like what you're doing is a joke. And there's no chance. Doesn't matter. Yidam v'yishtoik, keep on doing your own. As Rabbeinu says to Reb Nosson, you have no clue what Hashem wants from you. We are all doctors. We're all mevinim on ourselves. I don't do this, and I don't do this, I'm not this, I'm not this, I'm not this, I'm not this, look, and I'm worthless, blah, 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 blah. You don't know what Hashem wants from you. Don't have a clue. Yishma bizyoinoi, yidom v'yishtrik. Bezat Hashem, tomorrow we'll start explaining the mechanism at play that takes the silence, accepting the derision and shame and silence makes you, puts you in the position, you know, that you're doing tshuva. Why that process is the main, the crux of the tshuva process. So we continue tomorrow.